Right, starting out in our child's pose. Here we are. Big breath here. You know what to do. Huge inhales, expand the whole entire torso. And huge exhales, pull the belly button into the spine. All right, whatever energy level you feel like moving at today, let your breath be big here no matter what. Why? Because it's the best thing we can do to give our whole torso a massage from the inside. So such therapeutic expansion from within. We feel a lot of release in the tissues of the back, the rib cage, all those little intercostals between the ribs. And with each exhale, perhaps we could feel the hips drop a millimeter lower. The head gets a little heavier. And then over time, perhaps this posture changes a little bit. Maybe you wiggle a little differently. Maybe you notice, oh, hey, man, I'm right-handed and my right side is kind of tight and my right shoulder tends to curl down toward my right knee a little more than the left side. Okay, I'm speaking to you from my own experience, but maybe you notice something like that. Breathe deeply. Find where you're holding on. Where are you feeling stiff exactly? And breathe deeply and focus all your awareness on those places. All right, how much more can you let your jaw relax? How much more could you spread open your armpits toward the ground? And then for your next few breaths, just enjoy breathing deeply. Find that complete breath. Maybe lengthen the breath another second for the inhale and the exhale. But spend these breaths watching your thoughts. Okay, taking a little Zen moment here just to be the observer, watching your thoughts pass by, arise, and they go away. And then another one arises, and another one goes away. And we can just watch that. We don't have to get caught up. We can make that choice. We look at unpleasant thoughts. We look at pleasant thoughts. We look at things that we might label as good or bad, but we don't see any of that because we don't have to get caught up in it. We can just observe. Maybe one more big breath here. And it might feel nice at this point in the day, at this point in the month, just to sigh it out. Big exhale through your mouth. Feels nice sometimes. And then let's come up to hands and knees. All right, here we are. Let's take our hands wide and our feet kind of wide. And then kind of circle the hips out. And the shoulders out, just kind of revolving over hips and shoulders. And let's take that back the other way. Okay, and then you can bring your knees back under your hips and your hands back under your shoulders, but we'll get the right leg out behind. Point that toe, and let's start to draw circles from the hip. So like you're drawing circles behind you, all coming from your hip. Okay, so if you notice the knee and the ankle moving, try to lock them in. Try to really strengthen and control this movement from the hip. Okay, let's make the circles a little bigger, wrapping that belly button in toward the spine so we don't tend to drop the belly button. And let's reverse them. Let's push through the heel this time though. Wrap that belly button in. Okay, keeping that right hip internally rotated. And then let's bring it back to center. Bend the knee. Think of pressing the heel to the ceiling. Press, press. And let's do this a few more times. Wrap the belly in. Maybe send the heart a little bit more forward. And then press it up and hold. Maybe pull the heel in towards your glute. But think of your quad, the front of your right thigh, kind of spreading open here. Feel your hamstring getting a little bit warm as it works to pull the heel in and your glute. Nice stretch for your glute. One more big breath here. And let it go. Go ahead and extend that right leg. Drop the foot to the floor and press back through the calf. Oh, nice little calf stretch. And then let's transition it to a supported side plank. So we'll drop the right heel. And then point the left lower leg to the left. We can reach up with the right hand, and we are magically here. So fidget until you feel pretty good here. But when you start to feel grounded, let's start to press through the outer edge of the right foot. You might even peel up your arch. Feels good in your ankle, okay? And that left elbow is a little bit bendy. You should always be able to bend it a little bit. And let's strengthen and lengthen that right hand and open up the shoulder. So almost like you're reaching out and pulling back your hand at the same time. How would that even feel? You would activate all the muscles in that arm and shoulder and even the chest. And let's rewind it. Push through the palm this time. All right, as you're ready, reach up, hold. We're going to lift the top leg, the right leg. Internally rotate that hip. So when you look at your right toes, you'll notice they're pointed slightly downward. If they start to point up, then you would be externally rotating. So internally, please, and we'll lift, whew, and lower. Notice we can't lift it very high and keep it internally rotated. Let's take a few like that, lift. And lower. You can even put your hand on your hip. Feel it working. Okay, good stuff. Next, lift and hold. And let's just take a few breaths here. Okay, maybe reach that right hand very far away from your right foot. Reach both of them a little longer. One more big breath in here, just opening up that whole right side. And then let it go. We're just going to rest here for a few breaths. Right foot on the floor, right hand reaching overhead. All that tissue that you just kind of strengthen, see if you can soften a little bit here. Nice breath. Maybe bending that right elbow and kind of peeling the armpit and the front of the shoulder open a little more. One more big breath in right here. And we're letting it go. Coming down to hands and knees. Tuck your toes here. Let's get off our hands for a bit. Walk your hands back to your feet. Let's just hang. Hang and swing. Maybe grab your elbows. Make sure that your upper body really is hanging, okay? So if you notice that your ribs are up by your hips and your spine is really curling, bring it down. Just bend your knees, okay? Feeling the legs gradually open up. From here, we're going to bring it back down to hands and knees. So palms on the ground, hands and knees. Let's get the left leg out behind. Pointy toe and slightly internally rotate that left hip so we keep that belly button wrapped up as well. And we're going to draw a little circle with the left big toe. And sometimes it's nice to just keep it small and slow. And really stabilize from the core, and then we can grow the circle. So once you feel really good about that belly button wrapping to spine, heart moving forward, kind of stability, make them bigger. And then let's reverse it, but push through the heel. Push. Okay, try to keep this movement super isolated. So if you notice your left hip coming with you, pull it in. Okay, Let it go. Go ahead and drop. Oh, sorry. I forgot one thing. Don't let it go yet. Bend the knee. Press the heel to the ceiling. The knee comes up. The knee comes down. Ooh, I almost forgot that. That was dangerous. Okay. Press it up. Lift that belly button. Tuck that hip under. Glute is working. Okay, next time you press up, hold right there. Maybe pull the left heel in close. Lift that knee a little bit higher. Make sure we're wrapped under in the hip. One more big breath. Now let it go. Extend that left leg. We're dropping the toes and pressing back through the heel. Nice little calf stretch. And then as you're ready, drop the left heel. Transitioning to a supported side plank. We're taking the right toes to point to the right. And the left hand reaching up. Okay, I'll spin around to meet you while you fidget and make it just right. So make sure the right elbow has a slight micro bend in it, please. We don't want to lock it. Lock that. And we'll press down the outer edge of the left foot, peeling up the arch. Feels nice. Okay, now let's move this left shoulder around. So reach out, but plug the shoulder in at the same time and circle it out. Okay, maybe you just close your eyes here. Just notice how it feels to move. Kind of diving into your other senses when you're practicing is refreshing. And when you eliminate one of your senses, the other ones kind of light it up. Okay, take it back around. Do you ever notice how many weird crackles and pops your body makes when you're practicing? It's kind of fascinating if you just close your eyes and listen. Okay, reaching up, pause that left hand. We're getting the left leg up. Internally rotating, please, in the left hip. Tap the floor and lift the leg parallel with the ground. Tap, lift. Keep breathing, okay? Maybe put your hand on that left hip. It's nice to feel. The tissue is working. Okay, keep the belly button wrapped in. Keep that internal rotation. It's tempting to externally rotate a little bit. Okay, lift and hold and breathe. Maybe reach this left hand out very far away from the left side. Reach as long as you can through that side. Breathe and reach. Wrap the belly button in. Might feel good to peel the chest open a little bit here. One more big breath and let it go. Maybe drop that left foot to the floor. Reach the left fingertips almost at the floor over your head. Take a few breaths here. Okay, maybe just letting that left side peel open at the armpit and shoulder a little bit with a bent arm. And as you're ready, friends, let's bring it down. Coming down through hands and knees. Tuck your toes and walk your hands all the way back to your feet again. Let's take a little time here. So try this. Bend your knees nice and deeply and take the feet kind of wide. And then we'll just try bending one knee at a time and extending. So if your hands don't quite come to the floor here, no problem. See if you want some blocks. Okay, I have some invisible blocks here to show you. Also, you can just really bend your knees, okay? Who says you have to straighten them out completely? You don't. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to bend into the right knee, pause. Go ahead and reach up with your left hand. Big breath in. And exhale, bring it down. Let's switch sides. Bend into the left knee, ground into that left hand under the left shoulder. Inhaling here, right arm reaches up. Nice twist. Exhale to bring it down. Switch sides, right side down. Inhaling, left side up. Okay, could you just do this a few times side to side? A nice gentle twist. Nothing crazy. Can use your blocks. You want to feel a expansion happening across your chest on the way up. Next time you come down, we're going to come on up. Okay, so ground into your feet. Inhale here. Roll yourself up, reaching up tall. Think of even lifting your heart and reaching back behind you a little bit if it feels okay. And then exhale here, drop down into your chair posture. Our feet are nice and wide, so this feels like a nice squat we could maybe drop low into. And inhale, back up to standing. Maybe lift that heart and lean back a little bit. And exhale, fold, bend your knees, palms come down. With your inhale, heart is walking forward. With your exhale, drop your knees, drop your chest to hover just above your thumbs, looking forward, pulling your elbows in. Could you lift your belly as you drop your rib cage? Inhale, press it back to hands and knees. Let's do that again, just like that, okay? Exhale, wrap the belly in, drop the heart, look forward, elbows in. Keep that long neck. Inhale, back up to hands and knees. Just one more time, okay? Exhale here. Drop that heart. Look forward. Inhaling here, just slide your belly down toward the floor and pull your heart forward. We are magically in a cobra. Okay, and exhale, bring it down. And then let's actually take a few more cobras. So let's inhale, pull the heart up and forward. And exhale, roll it down. And take a few more breaths like this. I'm just going to give you some food for thought in cobra, some exploration fuel. So cobra's great when we talk about what do we need to do to undo the effects of sitting in front of a computer and driving and cooking and bending over other things and other people all the time, okay? We need to open up the chest, and that's what we're doing here, guys. So maybe take your hands out to the side. You can come up on your fingertips even. Ground those heavy hips, please, as you inhale and pull your heart up a little more. You have a little more space here, okay? Make sure it feels good. Pull on the inhale. Release on the exhale. But keep that pubic bone super heavy if you're gonna do some nice back bending, okay? We want to think of opening up all the tissue in the front body that gets so locked up. Move a little bit side to side here. All right, and next time you come down, palms are down, tuck your toes. Let's come up to hands and knees. And then let's find a down dog, kind of a nice, friendly down dog, walking it out. Okay, shaking the head. All right, friends, as you're ready, bring it back down to hands and knees. And let's get our wrists. Let's get a really nice wrist stretch here. So let's get the palm down, fingers pointed at the knees, and we can roll up and down on this. And if you like, if you want to really a really nice one, you can just walk your hands out further so that you're almost on a hands and knees, and you can think of sitting back on your heels and peeling your palms up and down like that. All right, and let's try the other side, palm up. Okay, and then this one we want to think of kind of rolling around on it. All right, that should feel good. It should feel really nice. All right, my friends. From hands and knees, let's take the right foot forward, plant it by the right hand, and we'll start to kind of circle the hips around, kind of move it all around. And then we'll take a little low lunge, okay? So find your very sustainable low lunge, and then you can use the right leg to press up. Okay, and here we are. So we're starting to activate the legs toward each other. Right? A little bit of squeeze between your knees. And then lift that belly button up and in. So as the knees squeeze together, the belly button kind of rises in and that core gets longer and stronger. And think of reaching up here, lift your heart. We'll take a few more breaths here. I really want you to activate this posture to the energy level that you desire. So if you're really looking for a strong, warm practice at the moment, here you are. You might even tuck your back toes and lift your back knee. You be the decider there. If you want to take it more low and slow, your hands are down under your shoulders and you're just kind of hanging your head. So somewhere on that spectrum is you, and you're taking a couple more breaths just to squeeze the knees together, maybe with 5% of your available strength. Maybe with 90, because you really want to rock right now. So you choose. One more breath here, guys. Okay, we're going to twist. So with your exhale, bring your hands together in front of your heart and take your left elbow to the outside of the right knee. We're going to hook it on there and look to the right and contemplate things for a moment. I'll spin around to face you. Okay, continue some degree of activity and engagement between your knees, okay? Anywhere from 5 to 99%. Okay, maybe even the back knee is lifted if you're still kind of enjoying that kind of challenge. But maybe right now, what you want to do is open your arms wide and look up at that top hand. Maybe you want to keep your hands together, but take a few breaths here with your long spine. Okay, long neck, the shoulder blades are moving away from your ears, and your heart gets a little bigger with each inhale. One more big breath here, guys. And with your exhale, bring it down. Okay, if your hands aren't already under your shoulders, do put them under your shoulders. And at this point, we can move the left knee back a little bit, perhaps, okay, because we're a little bit warmer. The hips are naturally going to sink lower. And let's rock forward and back. Okay, I'm going to give you kind of a low key option, and that's what we're doing right now. Okay, more of a higher energy option would be to lift the back knee, and the front leg pretty much stays the same as in the other more low key version. But you see with the back knee lifted, we just get a little bit more in the legs. So take a few more. And then we'll settle into opening up the back of this right leg. So you're pulling back on your hip. Your right hip is moving toward the back of the mat. Your left hip is moving toward the front of the mat. And whatever you're feeling along the back and side of the right leg should be pleasant. It should not be unpleasant. You can have a block under your hands. Really flex that right foot for this last breath. And let it go. We're putting that right foot back on the floor, left knee down. Take a moment here just to hang. Okay. Hands under shoulders, a slight bend in the elbows. Let's cultivate a little softness in that joint, right? And then maybe today, maybe not, you come down to your left elbow. And then we maybe have the right elbow. Maybe even walking the right foot a little further out to the right. And could we put a little activity between the knees, maybe just 5%, and allow the hips to soften 1 millimeter lower. Let your head hang. Find just the minimum amount of effort. What is the bare minimum? Let's explore that right here. Shoulders moving away from ears still. Hips level with the floor still. All right, we're peeling ourselves up out of this very slowly. So take your time coming on up to your hands if you were down on your elbows. Taking the right knee back to hands and knees. And let's take a little down dog. Let's just see how it feels. A little diagnostic down dog. Notice anything different about the back of the right leg? Maybe, maybe not. Okay, no expectations. Let's keep moving. Let's inhale, heart moving forward. Find a plank with or without your knees on the ground. And exhale, walk to your hands and fold. Inhale here, roll it up. Again, maybe lift your heart a little extra as you wrap your belly button in. And exhale, sit down into that chair. Lift your heart as you wrap the belly button in. Nice, inhaling to standing. Maybe another little back bend here. And exhale, big fold. Palms are down, inhaling here, back to a plank. And exhale, knees down, heart drops between thumbs. Look forward, just like we did before. Let's do this two more times. Inhale, plank, with or without your knees on the floor. And this time, maybe come hover knees, chest, and chin. Maybe you hover knees, chest, and chin, looking forward. One more time, hover up to plank. And exhale, knees, chest, and chin. Coming forward to your cobra on the inhale. And exhale, let it down. Let's take another round of cobras, okay? Now, maybe put your hands wide with your fingertips up and experiment with kind of a weird moving cobra. I really like that. Or maybe focus more on a low-key cobra, keeping your hands under your shoulders. Find a little bit more space in your heart. Okay, that's all I ask. Whatever variation you like best, you're opening up that heart a little bit. Maybe one more breath. And let it go, guys. Come on up through hands and knees. And down dog. Meet you there. Just walking it out. And as you're ready, back to hands and knees. And let's get the left foot forward by the left hand. And we'll start to kind of circle it out. Moving the hips all directions clockwise and counterclockwise a few times. And then as you're ready, we'll come up into our lunge. So maybe move the right knee back a little bit since we're a little warmer on this side perhaps, but we use the left leg to come up. And then you're just gonna find your lunge. You're just gonna go right into it, okay? So there's so many variations on this lunge spectrum, but no matter what variation you've chosen, there's at least a little activity between your knees, okay? Mula Bandha, the belly button is always lifting in. Okay, if you're up in your lunge, your heart might be lifting, your shoulders might be dropping down your back. And for the ultimate expression of this lunge, you could tuck the back toes and lift the back knee like a tree trunk. So find what works best for you here. A few more breaths, activate the legs. Find alignment, find a little bit more length in your spine. And as you're ready, guys, big breath in and exhale, hands down in front. Send the right elbow to the outside of the left knee. And turn over to look to the left and take a moment to settle in. I'll spin around to meet you. So remember, you could have the back knee up at this point to make it more challenging and more warming, or you could put both hands down underneath your shoulders to make it less challenging. So we're kind of in the middle here with the back knee down, twisting, hands moving toward heart. Breath, long spine. Okay, perhaps a little challenge here to open your arms out wide. Your right fingers would tickle the floor, your left fingers would reach up. Press through that back knee or that back heel, whatever's back there. If you have the knee down, press through the knee, foot, press through the foot, but long spine. Big breath. And one more big breath in here, guys. And exhale, bring the back knee down if it was up. Hands down inside that front leg. And we'll start to really sink down into this lunge. So maybe move the back knee back a little bit. We might have a lot of extra space at this point. A little bend in the elbows. Let the head hang. If your breath and your heart rate are elevated, just notice that and try slowing them down by intentionally slowing your breath. Letting the head hang, leveling off the hips too, something we want to play with. And let's come down to the right elbow perhaps. Left elbow perhaps. Perhaps we're using a block here under the elbows. And perhaps that left foot kind of shimmies out a little bit more to the left. Breathe here a little bit longer. Okay, are you ready to come out? Hands and knees, here we are. Let's take a down dog moment just to feel it out. Okay, notice anything different about the back of the left leg now. Walk the heels out, roll the shoulders. Okay, and now let's flow a little bit. Let's clear the palate. Inhale, heart forward, plank, with or without knees. Exhale to your hands and fold. Inhale, roll it up. Maybe that little back bend here, guys. Lift your heart. Exhale, sit into that chair. Could we drop a little lower this time? Inhale to standing, maybe back extends here. And exhale, fold it. Palms are down. Inhale, that plank. Okay. Exhale, knees to ascension. Maybe hover, maybe touch down, guys. We'll do it two more times, just like before. Inhaling to plank. Exhaling, knees to ascension. One more. Bring it up. Nice challenge. And bring it down. All right, here for your inhale, slide forward into your cobra and then get comfortable in your sphinx with your elbows under your shoulders. Here we are. Let's make our long neck, of course. We know that's always one of our priorities is that long spine that we work so hard on. So with our long neck, we need to make sure we're protecting the low back as well by making that pubic bone a little extra heavy, okay, wrapping the belly button up away from the floor as the hips press down. Okay, that'll keep us stable and safe in the low back. And then let's grip the mat with the hands. Let's use the elbows to pull back and down. So the elbows press down and back. The heart pulls up and forward, but the hips are still grounded. Let's breathe. Sphinx. You have been here for thousands of years in the desert. So strong and stable with your big open heart. And your proud shoulders and your fierce claws. Okay, sphinxes, I will give you some options to play with now, okay? Some front body opening options, since that's kind of one of our little themes today. How would you feel about making sure your hips are heavy? Okay, promise me the hips are heavy. Press the tops of the feet down and maybe lift your elbows a little bit. Let's just hold right there. Now notice if your elbows are pointing out to the side, please point them straight down. We want those elbows pointed down. And how about walking your hands in towards you a little bit? You might even walk the hands out to the side. But remember that feeling of pulling down and back. Promise me there's no pushing. There's only pulling. And maybe today you just bend one knee and point one toe at the back of your head. And if you want to move it a little bit away from the floor, you can do that. Maybe the other knee bends, points at the back of your head. Maybe all the knees lift up off the floor, but keep pulling the heart up and forward, up and forward. One more big breath in here, sphinxes. And let it go. Come on down. Hug the floor. Let that back bend kind of wash over you, that magic back bend glitter. Okay, friends, your favorite shoulder stretch up next. So looking out at your left arm, make it into a right angle at the elbow, knowing that you'll adjust it over time. Okay, and then you'll roll onto that left side, looking to the right. Okay, adjust the left elbow here, make it just right. Okay, and then commit by tucking the left knee up and in. Maybe the right knee too. I'll spin around to face you. All right, over time, you'll get to know what each shoulder is gonna want on each side. Okay, so you'll already probably know just from doing it a few times that those sides might be different. And then we can, once we settle into this, because we'll be taking a few breaths here, we can opt to press a little bit with the right fingertips on the floor to deepen that shoulder opening. Or reach up with the right hand. Or drape the right arm across your back. Remember your long neck. And then with that right leg, if we want to open up that right hip, okay, feels nice in that hip flexor. We can extend the right leg. Let the foot rest more or less passively on the floor, but move the leg back. Keep breathing. I'm finding a lot more space on the left side of the chest. So for these next few breaths, please breathe so deeply. Like really impress yourself with how much air you can bring in and how much you can press out. Can you feel your rib cage expanding against the floor? So powerful. Maybe one more big breath here. And as you're ready, untangle yourself out of this. We're rolling out and first adjusting that right elbow into a nice 90-degree bend. Okay, roll onto that right side, adjust that bend. All right, I like mine to be a little more than 90 degrees. Okay, maybe you might like the same if you're right-handed and you tend to get tight in that right side. And then we commit by tucking the right knee up and in. I'll spin around to face you again. Right, so maybe knees are stacked. Maybe the left leg is long, okay? Getting that left hip flexor to open up. Maybe the left arm reaches up. Or drops across your back. Just get it out of the way. All right, so every breath, we're adding a little bit more space to the right side of the chest. Feel the rib cage expand and contract. Okay, for these next few breaths, make your inhales and exhales so big. Okay, shock yourself with how much air you can take in. Maybe one more, opening up this right side of the rib cage from the inside. And as you're ready, let all of this go. Come on back to your belly. Hands under shoulders. And come on up through hands and knees. From here, guys, let's take a little modified child's pose. We'll point the right knee back, and then over to the left, and then down at the floor. So your femurs, your thighs are now crossed, and then you can sit back onto your right arch. You're just going to sit right on it, And your left leg is kind of weirdly stacked over your right, okay, to some degree. And from here, you can just sit if this is quite enough and you're just happy to sit here. You might want to put your fingertips on the floor in front of your hips with your long spine. Start to walk your fingers forward. Okay, we're going to take some breaths to do this, so you have time. There's no rush. Just think of gradually just kind of allowing yourself to fold over time over your legs. What would it be like if we, instead of pressing our body into these postures, what if we just allowed ourselves to naturally fold? Maybe one elbow comes down. Maybe another elbow comes down. Maybe we drop the head. Big breath into the back of the body. Low back. All right. If you came down on your elbows, come back up on your hands. And we're just going to move this left foot a little bit away from your hips. So just move it away a little bit. And then you can sit your hips in between your feet. And take a little time arranging yourself. I'll turn to show you that we want our knees close. But to make this easier, we can bring our feet closer to our hips. Okay. And to make it a more challenging, we can move the feet away from our hips. So find something that you feel comfortable experimenting with and then settle in. And let's make sure that both hips are heavy on the ground. We'll probably need to put a little extra weight in the left hip. Close your eyes here. We're just breathing. That's all. Just existing here in this posture. Okay, as you take a few more breaths here, you may want to adjust it by moving the feet away from you or closer to you to make it feel just right. And then also, just like before, you might want to take your fingertips in front of your hips and start to lengthen your heart forward as if you intended to reach your heart way far past your knees. That's the direction that it's headed. Okay, keep breathing. We'll take a few more breaths here so you have time to experiment. There's no rush. Really getting into that outer hip. Okay, and inner. SI joint. If you have any sciatic pressure, if you're a runner or a cyclist, you're feeling this. Maybe a few more breaths here. It feels good. If you want even more from this, you can think of trying to squeeze your knees together, okay? Mula Bandha, just like when we're in those standing postures, you can use that here to really activate and enliven your postures. You can use it on the ground or in the air. Keep breathing, guys. Maybe one more breath. Just feels really nice. And as you're ready, we'll transition this posture one more time. Okay, we'll bring that left, that's the right heel. Scoot it in close to your left hip. So bring that right heel in. And we'll pick up this left leg and plant the left foot on the outside of the right knee. Okay, just somewhere that feels nice. Make sure we get that left hip down and our long spine, of course. And then the left knee will be held close by the right arm. Okay, so long spine inhales. And look over that left shoulder, exhale. Long spine inhale. Look behind, exhale. Take a few more here, guys. Perhaps you want to use your left fingertips down behind you. It's nice to kind of press the floor a little bit more here. Okay, some of you want even more from this twist. To you guys, I say, take your right elbow to the outside of your left knee, and kind of like you're saying hi to someone on your left, you can use the elbow pressing against the knee. But get that left hip down, okay? Watch out for that. Breath. Have you lost your breath? All right, as you're ready, spiral out of this and turn towards your left leg. And we're gonna pick this left foot up. Now we've got our hip nice and warm, so we might as well open up the low back while we're here. So just pick your left foot up and just kind of pick it up in the air. And don't yank it, just gently hover it. And if you'd rather just keep it resting on that right knee, no problem, no pressure. But if you can pick it up, comfortably pick it up. Ground that left hip, make a long spine, and let's play a little bit here. How do you feel about taking the left foot in your right elbow? I know it sounds weird, but try it out. It might work, okay? If this is something that you just want to kind of hang out here and work on and think about, do that. If you want to travel onward, wrap the right hand around your left calf, and then wrap your left elbow over your left thigh. And you can, your hands can join, and you have a baby now. Your left leg is your baby. So sit up tall. Allow the left hip to be heavy and gently move your baby side to side. Now you can kind of play here because you've made the left leg weightless. So you can let go in it and experiment with rolling on the head of the femur, the sit bone down on the ground, and then extending and flexing the knee. Okay, should feel really nice. And then for your last few breaths, without any pain at all, hug your baby in close to your heart. Long spine, big breath. All right, maybe one more big breath here. And let all of that go. All right, we might put 2 feet down here and just take a few windshield wipers just to kind of get the crackles out and notice how the hips are feeling. And then as you're ready, you point both your knees to one side. You can come back to hands and knees. And here we are. So let's do another side, that modified child's pose. So we'll point the left knee back to the right. And down, your thighs are now crossed, and you'll just sit back on your left foot. Okay, you're sitting on your left arch now. And the right leg is kind of draped more or less neatly across the bottom leg. So long spine, see if you can get your fingers down beside you. And maybe just being here is enough. And this is nice, isn't it? So stay here or continue walking your fingers forward. Remember, your heart moving forward is the priority. Okay, that's the priority. The spine will round, but let the heart moving forward still be the priority. Okay, maybe an elbow comes down, maybe two elbows. Hang your head, but keep the shoulders moving away from the ears. Keep the heart moving forward. Let the right hip be soft and heavy. Alrighty. You ready to walk yourself up out of this nice hip and low back stretch? Okay, let's take it a little deeper. Let's move the right foot a little further away. Okay, and then sit the hips in that spot between the feet. And so now we're setting up a cow face posture. So the knees are stacked. The feet can come in for less opening in the hips if it's too much. The feet can move away for more opening if you want more. Okay, rock into that right hip. We know it needs to be extra heavy for us to get the most for our time here. And let's get our spine nice and long. Just enjoy yourself. Allow this to unfold naturally without feeling like there's anywhere that you need to be. Okay, the lower we keep our expectations on and off the mat, the more fun everything is. Okay, we get to be like a child. So perhaps we roll forward into this, perhaps not. Remember your long neck and your heavy right hip. All right, guys, such a great stretch for opening up that outer hip. Okay, as you're ready, we're coming up out of this and we're transitioning it into that little twist. Okay, so we're just gonna move the left foot a little closer in. Just take it in a little bit if you moved it out away from your hips. And we'll just plant the right foot squarely on the floor outside that left leg. And the left arm will hold the right knee close. Okay, we have a long spine on our inhales and a big twist on our exhales, looking over that right shoulder. Okay, remember that you are actively hugging that knee inward as you're pressing the hip down. So you're kind of opposing yourself. You're kind of resisting yourself right now, kind of dancing with your own strength. Okay, and maybe for these last few breaths, put your right fingers behind you for a little bit of extra support and oomph and length in your twist. And maybe we'll take the left elbow to the outside of the right knee. Say hi to someone on the right. And big twist. Okay, long spine. Inhale, still. Strong belly exhales. And get that right hip low. Maybe one more breath here. Go ahead and twist yourself out of this. Okay, are you ready to do the right side? Okay, we call it the rocking your baby, okay? So we'll start just by picking the right foot up and just experimenting with picking it up, and that might be too much. In that case, we would just set the right foot on the left knee and breathe deeply with a long spine. If you're feeling great, you can pick that foot up and just experiment with moving it around. And then maybe we put that right foot on the inside of the left elbow and the left hand can hold that right calf, okay? Rocking your baby, and maybe the right arm comes around and we have two hands holding this giant leg up. So do support the weight of your leg up away from the floor. How would it feel if you even tried to lift your own leg up off of the floor as you're sitting down into that right hip? Let's take a few breaths here. Rock your baby. Maybe move it into your chest, hold it close. All right, maybe one more breath here. Hold your baby close. A lot of heat in that hip, maybe. And then we're letting it go. Let's take a few more windshield wipers. Okay, how do your hips feel? I hope they feel great. As you're ready, guys, tuck your hands behind your knees and go ahead and roll onto your back. Take a moment here, just rolling it out. You can think of grabbing one hand in each knee. One hand on each knee, kind of circling. And then let's get all the legs up in the air. Let's just invert for a little while, circling at your ankles. All right, I like doing figure eights in one direction for a little while, and then figure eights in the other direction. We want to do all the things that an ankle can do, right? And then write your name. And then draw your favorite animal. All right. And then let's bring the right knee in. Go ahead and let the left leg go. And then let's gently move that right knee in toward the chest. Ground those shoulder blades. And let's take a few breaths here. Okay, right knee is moving toward the center of your chest, toward that sternum. And let's take a little time moving the right knee away from the midline as if you could pull it into your armpit. As a matter of fact, could you take your right forearm and your left forearm around that right knee? Do we need to reground the shoulder blades? Nice breath here, trying to pull the knee into your armpit. All right, as you're ready, we're softening up on that knee bend, and we'll just use the left hand to make this right knee go to the left, okay? Look to the right and set up your twist. I'd like us to take about 5 or 6 breaths here, so please get comfy. With something that may kind of make it just right for you is moving your shoulder blades a little bit in the direction of your right knee, so a little bit out to the left, so your twist is more twisty. Long spine inhales, belly button to spine exhales. So if you feel great here, you can start to play a little bit, start to explore this posture. What would happen if we enlivened this outer right hip a little bit? And as the left hand rests on the right knee, pressing it downward, the right knee presses gently up into the left hand. They find a homeostasis, they don't go anywhere, but there's engagement, there's activity. How does that feel? If you're still feeling fantastic, you can experiment further. I'm going to have to move to show you guys this. With extending your right knee a little bit, you can walk your hand out toward the foot maybe, or maybe the somewhere on the shin is better, and you can extend partially or fully. It's just something else to play with. Close your eyes here, feel your heart rate starting to slow down. Your breath becoming softer and cooler with each round. As this twist cools your body and recalibrates it. And as you're ready, we'll bring the right leg back in. Go ahead and let it go. Let's bring the left knee in. Fingers interlaced behind the thigh or in front of the shin. And we'll move the left knee toward the center of the chest, like you're intending to put it on your sternum. And then move it away from the midline as if you intended to put it in your armpit. Maybe using your left forearm and your right, but ground those shoulder blades. Okay, ready to soften up on this knee, and we'll turn this into a twist, taking that right knee, sorry, that left knee to the right. Okay, looking to the left. So set up your twist. Maybe make sure that your hips and shoulders are in the same line so that you get that most twisty twist. Looking to the left. Long spine inhales. Strong belly button to spine exhales. Okay, option here. If your knee is bent, the left knee, everything's feeling great, you can start to put a little bit of resistance between the right hand and the left knee. Take a couple breaths like that. Notice how it feels. And if everything's still going great, you can just partially extend the left knee. Think of walking the right hand out. And then maybe the leg extends partially or fully. Who knows? But nice opening along that glute and the low back. As you're ready, friends, roll out of this and come on through center and find your resting posture. You are here. Take a moment to become as comfortable, blissful, grounded as you'd like to be, and then settle into that posture. Allow your face to melt enough that a little smile can grow on it, please. Some face yoga. Eyebrows drift away from each other, and the tongue and the jaw are soft. And the breath comes as effortlessly through the nose as the waves come up and down on the beach. With each inhale, you are more expansive. And with each exhale, your body melts a little bit more down to the floor. And giving yourself this time just to be present and feel the sensations that you cultivated during your practice. Watch every thought and emotion. Fascinated compassion. Please keep resting as long as you can. I hope you feel very good. Thank you so much for joining me.